Hello, fellas. I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill. And yesterday, fellas, it was extremely, extremely good day. What do I mean by saying this is if you would pay attention at this number over there, you would notice we managed to get up to 100% on the Ruski Light. I can tell you that. Remember when the last week I said, oh my bananas, we had amazing session with a progetto. Right, remember this? With Ruski Light. Ping, 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 ping. You will see the stats of the session right there. If I remember correctly, we played over 30 battles. Yesterday I had like 10 hour stream. We played over 30 battles with Ruski Light and obviously some battles with a progetto. And with Ruski Light we managed to get, if I remember that correctly, it's like 2.8, 2.6 thousand damage and close to 3,000 assisting damage on average. Yesterday I was like a Superman, okay? It was, the session which we had was insane, and obviously yesterday I tried to focus on the game as much as we can, and I will share with you two battles in city maps with a light tank when we are dominating, when we are doing everything properly and we are eliminating enemies pretty much for free and we are doing a great stuff. So you are going to see, I don't want to show you Kempinovka battle, I don't want to show you Prokhorovka battle, because we had quite some of those and we get a good score. I want to show a city maps, because cities is the place where majority of the lights is suffering for obvious reasons. By the way, T55 is saying, как ты играешь Ruski Light? And you know what I said? So, fellas, what we are going to do right there, we are going to take this middle position and we want to see maybe someone is going to cross through the open field and hopefully we can punish them for their stupidity. But as you can see, it's not happening like this, unfortunately, and we cannot get any pre-shots whatsoever, which is kind of weird because I was expecting to see someone. But as you can see, they have a lot of forces on the field, and Mouse is going through the middle while saying piri 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 piri. So what I noticed, and in the first minute nothing happened, so we kind of want to relocate. We noticed that ML2, which is going through the open field, so I'm thinking how to punish him. Unfortunately, I did not manage it to find the clear shot on the ML, so I simply was thinking about shooting the 430, and right here I think I definitely can punish the ML into the side, so we are going to do this, right? We are reaching the side, and that was beautiful penetration, but oh bananas, the 3090 with APCRs right there, he's trying to do a bad thing for us, and obviously he's doing that. We try to snap him, but unfortunately that was not the case. It doesn't matter, I am feeling very, very good right there. What we noticed immediately, they have someone which is capping the base, so what do we need to do? We need to punish him for his stupidity for obvious reasons. So we are going in front, and this poor soul T69 is taking one for the team. He is getting the snapshot into us, which is completely understandable because the angle was not so good, and the same annoying 3090. I am hissing on him like... unfortunately, I still can't catch him, and that was not the best shot from my side, so I can't do anything about that. So I'm simply leaving that 3090 over there, and we are going for this IS-3. Maybe we are going to get one side shot, and when you are playing with the light tanks, you are trying to be, let's say like that, as much annoying as possible without too much risks, however you are calling that. And remember, fellas, when I said I'm a hacker for the person which asked how to Grayish or whatever. I wasn't lying. Okay. The budget, I hit budget Amoriak and Progetto hit budget Amoriak once again and he exploded. Well, hashtag never lucky. Anyways, fellas, the T30 is going... is going quite aggressively for us, but it doesn't matter. We are getting the side shot to the T30, and the T30 is not going to go for us. I tried kind of to side scrap against him, and obviously I bounced my shot. Well, what can you do? Nothing. The score is not looking so good. It is 5-6. So it's okay. I mean, it's pretty much equal right there, right? And what do we want to do? We want to get as much use as we can, right? So we are trying to punish this Amax for his stupidity, and unfortunately the Ruski gun handling is not looking that tasty and that good, and it's kind of sad. But it doesn't matter, because the Esterva is making some kind of stupidity, and he is taking one for the team from our side. We have a big large repair kit, so we are not wasting them, and the 430 is trying to get the shot through the through the rails right there, which is kind of complicated, but you know, I'm not too afraid of that, because he cannot get like super good angle. Anyways, S1 is eliminated. We have 3,300 damage, but we are just starting. There's still some hit points left in the battle, and we need to do whatever we can in order to get maximum use of all this. There is Ruski Light, which have full hit points over there. There is still this AMX Mouse, which have 300 hit points, so he's pretty much down to one shotable. Anyways, what do we want to do? We are just trying to pump the damage in the left and the right. One shot to the AMX, and now I'm thinking, brother from another mother, you beautiful, beautiful, beautiful Ruski Light, come to daddy. Ruski Light is taking one for the team. He have 500 hit points left. I'm trying to flank him like this, auto aim, and hit into their side. Meanwhile, there is a Mouse and T55 left, and pretty much we won this battle already. I'm trying to snap the T55. Unfortunately, I do not hit my shot, so the next, if I am going to not penetrate the shot on this guy, we are going to have the AP just in case. But fortunately, the luck was in my side, and right there I'm thinking, do I want to take one for the team? Do I don't want to take one for the team? Obviously, I want to. I thought that this guy is going to die after our shot, but that was not the case, and Mouse is going to hell. Cheers, Mega Pilot of War. 5,300 damage in 5,300 damage, 400 assisting damage in ends. It is city map after all, and we are playing with light tank. Yes, matchmaking was good right here, no doubts. But fellas, as wrong as it sounds, yesterday we had so many good battles in the city maps. It's crazy, and I believe if we have someone from the Twitch, I believe you are going to say, Skill, you are monster, you did everything properly yesterday. And indeed, it was the case. Yesterday was that day when, you know, everything is going smooth. It doesn't matter where. Is it in the game? Is it in work? Is it wherever? You get the point what I'm saying. So yesterday was that day. Anyways, fellas, let's go for another battle, because another one is going to be in Himmelsdorf. Let's go. And fellas, we are back in the Himmelsdorf. We have a tier 10 tanks against the tier 8 in the Himmelsdorf. It's obviously the pack of our hacks and everything, and here we are. And now what we are thinking about doing, guys, is very, very simple. I cannot go on top of the hill, because the AMX or 277 is going to eat me alive, or this UDES, which can play hull down. It's just not a good plan. So what we are thinking about doing right there, we are actually going down, and we will try to take the standard position, which is, in my opinion, standard. It is this. So from here you can try to shit on people which is playing over there, plus on top of that we can get some kind of use on the people which is playing over there, and if necessary we can push like this, we can push like this, we can retreat, we can do whatever we want. So that's what we are going to do, okay? So fellas, look, looks like enemy team is playing very, very aggressively right there. The 277 is making a hardcore pressure. The 39th is also in the front lines right there, which is crazy. And the Jet Panther is crossing like this. I think I need to get a shot. I need to get a shot. I need to get a shot. And obviously we managed to hit the Jet Panther, since we aim it well, and we are playing with a Ruski tank after all, even though I don't really like this tank gun handling. Let's say like that. And I am thinking, what to do? Oh boy, what to do? And I am thinking about picking in this way, maybe we are going to get some kind of use. And that poor Jet Panther, poor soul, he's making another mistake and we are punishing him for that. Now I said effing Ferrari, but we managed to make sure the tire pressure on the Ferrari tank is going to be shitter. Ferrari doing some stunts and he is taking another for the team. But what we noticed meanwhile we noticed that there is IS3 which is making some kind of mistake, so we punished him once in a butt. And now I'm thinking how to get more use of all this. We managed to spot the T44 100 R over there. By the way, for people who don't know, R means it's some kind of pack in Russian server. When people, it's some kind of collaboration. Basically, if you have certain internet services, you are getting this tank for free, if I understand how it works. Anyways, what we are doing right here, I am thinking about going for this oil, but maybe we can get the shot on the Jet Panther, and unfortunately, it's not the case, because it was kind of effed up angle. So far, 1,500 damage, 1,000 assisting damage as a start is not terrible, and I am thinking how to get maximum use of all this. Okay, Oho can be dangerous tank. If he is going to hit my side, he's definitely going to penetrate me, so I cannot do anything about that. But in the same time, I'm very brave cookie. I am thinking I need to go in, because otherwise we are not going to get enough use of all this, and I cannot stay over there, because I notice that the Waffelcock might go for us from the back, and I'm afraid. As you can see, the Waffelcock is peeking in the back, so I definitely cannot afford is the smooth drift right there, and we are making sure the Oho is going to be pregnant. That's it, finito, this guy eliminated. So the next thing, what do we want to do in this kind of situation? Majority of the forces is over there, but they still have one Arta. So what I'm trying to do, I'm trying to cross like this, and oh boy, T49 is waiting for us, but he had very, very slow reaction, and probably bad RNG. What that basically means, when the T49 shot right there, we need to go and kill the T49, but still there is Arta in front of you. I don't give a flying F. The T49 needs to die. T49 is dead. So now, clicker, glove on. So how you are feeling today? You are enjoying your gaming experience. You moved a lot from your spawn. Bad clicker. That's what we did right there, and I had a maximum pleasure. I said shoot into the wall, but clicker was not listening to me, so we needed to ignore this. Anyways, the next step for us, I was thinking, should I go over there or should I go here? And obviously I decided to go over there because they have more guns and in the same time more hit points in this side. So obviously, since I am aiming to get maximum use for myself, I am going in front and I am trying to get as much use as I can right there. And oh boy, the T-44. This car wreck, or however you are calling this, messed my way a bit, but it's okay. I'm not complaining. Shit happens. Let it be. Anyways, the T-44 is pulling back, and obviously I don't want to give him a free shot, and he had a very, very slow reaction, or maybe he's using outdated Mark of Excellence mod, which still is happening. By the way, people, if you have outdated Mark of Excellence mod, remember to update it, because otherwise you might get lagged in the game. Think about it. Don't use old products. Old Mark of Excellence mod, old milk, or whatever. Remember this. And fellas, are you ready for some quality gameplay right there? I believe you are. Watch this. Stunt. I dodged the shot, and that guy took one for the team in his butt, but it doesn't matter, fellas. You see, I mean, what we was doing yesterday is just crazy. Now we have a duel with a tier 9 medium tank, and this medium is not bad at all. Luckily he bounced one, and we are getting another shot in his side, and we are thinking what to do. He is face hugging you, but it doesn't matter, because I know what I'm doing, and we are trying to flank him like this, and he is going down. Oh boys, and what you are seeing right here, that's how we played yesterday. Majority of the battles was like this. You don't believe in me? You know what? I have one more battle. I mean, I could dig into my replays and I could get one more Ensk battle, if I remember correctly, where we managed to get very, very, very solid score. So why not? I mean, if I can give you extra content, and if you are enjoying to see this kind of stuff in the city maps, Why not to make a proper one and make instead of two videos, make three videos? Stay tuned, uno momento, we are going to show you one more. And fellas, we are back with the third replay and skill. What kind of tier 8 hacks you have? If you are community contributor, you are getting some kind of you are getting better in RNG and you are getting the best battles and the best maps as you can see, because you are playing in the camping off all the time with a light tank. In other words, fellas, like I mentioned it before, in order to mark this vehicle, you need to be super lucky. What do I mean by saying super lucky? I mean it. And yesterday was that day when we was when we did everything properly. And here you go, another city map, but we are trying to get a maximum use of all this. And fellas, I am feeling brave, okay? Anyways, how we are starting this battle? We are starting this battle from the middle and we managed to see the four guys which was crossing like this. So now, we know they have quite some forces in the city, which is not very good. But anyways, I am trying to get a good shot into the cover, into the 103, and we managed to get one. Hip hip hooray, life is beautiful. And now I'm thinking, do I want to go aggressively into the city or not? Should I go into the city or I should not go into the city? This is the most important question. And you know what? I decided to go for it. I decided to go and take this Vaza 120 live. So we are making some kind of pressure, because by sitting in the back in the city map with a light tank, it's not going to be the best score and you are not going to get the best result. Obviously, you need to risk it a bit for the biscuit, and that's what we are doing. So Vaza 120 took one for the team into the side, which is very, very nice. And now I'm trying to figure out what is happening. Looks like this Vaza 120 is going for us. So what do we want to do? We want to set the ambush right there. We are hitting him into the side, and luckily he is not reacting properly. So it's very, very beautiful for us. But don't you think I am thinking about stopping right there? Because there is M103 in front, so we are hitting him into the side right there, and I'm trying to figure out, do I want to peek once again or not? And obviously I'm peeking once again. I try to aim for a lower plate, but I changed my mind and I'm going for the cupola shot right there. And now I'm started thinking about Vaza 120. Vaza 120 is down to the one shot, so I went in front, but unfortunately he was dead before I reached him. But it doesn't matter, because M103 is waiting for us, and we are simply waiting for the killing shot right there. And obviously we are killing this guy. Now we are aiming for tracks to the cover for in order to get the maximum use of all this, because tracking damage is sweet, fellas. Tracking damage is love, tracking damage is life. And in the city map, since you cannot spot, you need to go for a tracking if you want to get the maximum use for all of all this, for obvious reasons. So Centurion 5/1 is waiting over there on the corner, so we will try to aim for a tracks, but unfortunately we are not hitting the tracks right there. And object 5 Object 705A is eliminating this guy from the game. Unfortunate, but what can you do? Anyways, I noticed a dart, and dart is biting me to eat him. And I really want to peek once again, because you know Arta and stuff, and Arta worked as a bite. But hey fellas, look at the bright side, at least we eliminated the Arta from the game. And currently situation is not very good. Enemies have a living train, I have only 500 hit points left, and oh boy, there is still a lot of things to do for us, and it's hard, fellas, it's definitely hard. So what am I thinking? I see MX50B which is pushing to the other side, and I'm thinking maybe I can get the shot. But currently MX50B is kind of safe unless he's going to peek, and obviously MX50B wants to check out who is living off this corner, and we managed to get the shot into this guy. Excellent. Now I am trying to set the ambush right here. I'm waiting till someone will peek, but that was terrible reaction time from my side, so unfortunately I did not manage to hit that guy. But the T49 is going in front, and I was aiming for T49, and I thought, oh boy, the T49 is going to kill us right there. But you know what? As you can see, that was not the case, and T49 was going for the cap, which was actually stupid. Unfortunately, RNG was saying eat Kaku skill, and we did not manage to penetrate the MX M103, but what can you do? Luckily, RNG said skill, I apologize, and kill this ELC even through the fence, and just make him suffer. And that's what we did. Meanwhile, MX is waiting till someone will peek like this, and he actually shot. Okay, never mind. It's okay. Not a big problem them whatsoever. The T-49 just shot into our 257, which is the hero of this battle. He's holding this side very, very well, and for obvious reasons I want to help him, and that was kind of sad aim because I aimed a bit too up. I was aiming for his turret. That was quite terrible aim, and it was a sad story. Anyways, they still have some forces over there. For example, they have that Borshik, they have a couple of guys over there, and fellas, we are going. This is the battles which we had yesterday. Borshik is going down like nothing. Now I'm thinking about this light tank. Do I want to go for him? No, yes, yes, no, pukst. Unfortunately, we managed to miss that shot, which was a very, very unfortunate RNG, but not much what I can do about this. Maybe this one will connect. Obviously, it will. So we have, he's down to the one shot for us. And now my plan is very, very simple. I need to track this Wafflecock and I need to kill this light. Let's start flexing. Let's start flexing, fellas. We are going in front and we have all plan in our head. So what we need to do? We need to go in front. We need to kill that light tank. We need to track this Wafflecock. This is the plan. Wafflecock is getting spotted. We are going in front right there. Where is that light? Light is still sitting on this corner, but obviously we managed to get a shot into the light tank. And oh boy, the Wafflecock is looking at us and and Wafflecock is taking our life. You know what? I don't care. Yes, we could get a 1,600 more use tracking or damage or whatever, but it's not bad. Here you go. This is the streak which we had yesterday. And I'm not even bothering to show the games which we had on the fields, because those games was even better if we are speaking about the scores combined. So after this video, fellas, you are going to see the scores of those three battles as usual, plus on top of that you will see some screenshots in what kind of average performance I had in this like 350 or 400 games while I was marking this vehicle. I can tell you that this Ruski light, I needed a lot of luck, and luckily luck was in our side yesterday. And I'm super blessed and I'm super happy. I hope you enjoyed this video, fellas. It was three battles, light tank trapped in the city, but we was using hacks, we was using our powers, we was using our brain, and everything was working very, very good. And definitely, fellas, we carried our weight. So thank you so much for watching. Also, patrons, I love you. Thank you so much for your support, fellas. I truly appreciate that. And for every single of you which is watching the video, and hopefully I am making a smile on your face, or alternatively I am giving you some tips and tricks in the game. Thank you so much for everything. See you next time, fellas. Skill is out. Peace.